Hello everybody, my name is Lars, I'm software engineer and consultant at PTV, and in today's Rock and Code session I want to show you how easy you can deploy a vector map with PTV Developer. You can look over my shoulder, I already created a default project, and I needed to install some additional packages. So we use React MapGL for rendering, and we also use MapLibre. And these are the dependencies you can install via a normal npm install command. And now let's dive into our main entry point of the application, the functional component app. And here we have some test command vector map so that you see on the right screen how the finished application will look like. And we want to have a vector map, so we need an additional component. And let's create it. We call it vector map. Yes. And we need some special ingredients that our vector map is running. So what we want to do is we need the API key that you can get for free at the PTV developer homepage. Let's take that. Then we need our map style URL to have nice shiny map themes. So let's just import it. Then additionally, we want to have a control so that we can zoom in and that we can zoom out. So we need just a constant that defines the control. Let's also save it. Then we need some kind of center of the map. So we want to have the center in Karlsruhe, and therefore we need longitude and we also need latitude. And then we can start with the logic of our vector map. So now you see that we have here a use callback hook from React, and we just inject the API key so that we are able to get back the vector information from PTV developer. And we also use MapLibre for rendering, so we have to state this in that map component. We have some basic style that we want to have a full screen map, so you need 100% width and you need 100% height. And you just call the getTransformRequest function to inject the API key. And then you add as some kind of child component the navigation control. And in order to be able to export that component and to use it in the main app.js file, we have to export it. And then we need some additional imports to be able to use the use callback hook, and that we are doing now. So we just paste it below the API key. We save it. So we do not have any error messages now. And now let's go to the main component to just wire everything up. Let's copy and paste it. Let's start compiling. Now you already see the vector map. What you have to additionally do is you have to state that you really want to have a full screen map. So you have to adjust the height and you have to adjust the width. And when you zoom in and you zoom out, you see how smoothly everything is working. And especially when you are using high resolution displays or when you are developing mobile apps, vector map is the state of the art of map rendering, and you are not dependent on bitmap resolution on the server. So for me, it's absolutely fun to develop vector maps for mobile applications, and I do not want to miss it. And to sum up, so that you see the general structure, you have your main component, you have the vector map component, you have an API key that you can get for free. And inside the vector map component, you have to define which kind of rendering theme you want to have. So we used this shiny theme. and you have to state where you want to place your main point of the map, your sender point, and the initial zoom level. And then you just state the style, you transform the request and inject the API key, and you additionally add the navigation control, and then you are set up and you can start logging. That's for today. In the next episode, we want to put nice markers, nice polygons and polylines on the map. Stay tuned and subscribe to the channel.